गुड मॉर्निंग टू माई डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू अनदर क्लास ऑफ इंग्लिश ग्रामर. टूडे आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू चैप्टर नंबर 28, टाइटल्ड वर्ड्स ऑफन कन्फ्यूज्ड. वी कम अक्रॉस मैनी वर्ड्स माई डियर स्टूडेंट्स दैट साउंड सिमिलर बट टोटली हैज डिफरेंट मीनिंग और स्पेलिंग्स. Today, let me explain you what are they called. Yeah, they are called homophones. Homo means similar, phones means sound. So, definition of homophones. What are homophones? Homophones are words which have the same pronunciation but spelt differently and have different meaning. So, they are known as homophones. Now let me explain you some of the homophones given in your books which has different spellings and meanings but they sound similar. So first one is accept and except. Accept means to agree or to receive something. And accept means not including or excluding. The uses of these homophones in the sentences are, all except Raman were present in class. We cannot accept your offer. Next one is bare, bear, bear, bear. So bare, bear means not clothe or to uncover. B-E-A-R bare means to be patient, means calm. His feet were bare even in the cold weather. I could not bear the insult and left my job. Next one is C-S-T caste. C-S-T caste. C-S-T caste means a group of actors. C-S-T caste means a social class. What is the caste of this play? India has earned a bad name for its rigid caste system. Now number 4. Dairy, diary. Dairy means milk products. Diary means daily writing experiences. Now use in the sentences. The dairy started by Sidhu Bhai soon became very popular. Annie Frank's diary has become the best seller. Number 5. F-A-I-R, fair. F-A-R-E, fair. Here, F-A-I-R fair means impartial, treating equally. And F-A-R-E fair means the amount of money you pay to travel by bus, train, taxi, etc. So let's use them in sentences. He is known to be a fair and important judge. What is the plane fare from Delhi to Dubai? Next, H-A-I-R hair, H-E-I-R hair. H-A-I-R hair means fine thread that grow in a mass on your head. H-E-I-R hair means right to inherit, means to take a person's money or property. Now their use in the sentences. She cut off her long beautiful hair to buy a present for her husband. Prince Charles is the heir to the British throne. Next, L-O-S-E, lose, L-O-O-S-E, lose. L-O-S-E, lose means to lose patience, means not to stay calm. And L-O-O-S-E, lose means not tied up, means free. The use in the sentences, do not lose your temper. The dog bites people if he is left loose. Now next, P-R-A-Y, pray, P-R-E-Y, pray. Here, P-R-A-Y, pray means to speak to God. And P-R-E-Y, pray means an animal that is hunted and killed by another for food. So, let's see the use in the sentences. The lion is a beast of prey. Let us all pray to God to keep ourselves healthy, wealthy and wise. Now, next. Number 9, R-A-I-N, rain, R-E-I-G-N, rain. Here, R-A-I-N, rain means the drops of water that falls from the sky. REIGN rain means to rule a country. Let's use them in sentences. It began to rain as soon as we stepped out. Akbar's reign lasted for almost 50 years. Number 10. Stationary. Stationary. S-T-A-T-I-O-N-A-R-Y. Stationary. S-T-A-T-I-O-N-E-R-Y. Stationary. The pronunciation is same, but their meanings will be different. Let's see. So, S-T-A-T-I-O-N-A-R-Y, stationary means not moving. S-T-A-T-I-O-N-E-R-Y, stationary means writing equipments. So, the use in sentences. In olden days, people believed that the earth was stationary and the sun revolved around it. The school stationery shop does not have fevi sticks. So, my dear students, these are the solutions of exercise 1 to 6. So, note them neatly in your English grammar book. And if you have any queries regarding any word or spellings, please, you can text me. So, today we have learned some similar sounding words, meanings, or which are different from each other. So, this was all for today. I hope, my dear students, all have understood today's concept of homophones. So, we'll meet in our next video. Till then, goodbye. God bless you all. Thank you.